Everyone has their own story occurring on a daily basis. Some pen it down and some never express it. On that day, I wrote a one, and when I had a glance to it, all the memories get framed up in a sequence. These are the golden memories which count in the end, and such memories will be remembered. So welcome back to the Andaman series, Day 2. We three were at a place where sun rises up at 4:50 a.m. And yes, we all have seen it. I can say, it was the best sunrise which we have ever seen. So early but so beautiful and eye-catching. What else you need when your day starts off with such a beautiful happening? It was a blessing for us. Today, our route was simple. We were heading towards the Havelock Island to explore more extremities of this place. We three were highly pumped up and our energy level was way too high. Within 1.5 hours, we were at Havelock. To be approx, it was 31.9 nautical miles from Portblair, and we were welcomed by the turquoise sea water, which itself was so beautiful for the eyes to see. We checked into our resort, had our lunch, rested for an hour, and rented bikes for the exploration of Havelock Island. The feel which we get while driving bikes in the roads of Havelock was so radiant, like it had given us a plinth to take off from and fly as high as we can go. So we headed towards the Radhanagar beach and stayed there till the sunset.
We get lost, we can get high. Because me gone, I feel alive. Anywhere, anyway, I will love you.
I will love you.
We rule the world, just you and I. Just let me tell, we walk the line. But now nothing's gone wrong, I'll take a shot for you. Give me love, keep me close. Never let you go.
In the end, what are we holding? Is it memories or the moments or the gratitude or the enchantments? Well, I wish I could know. I have asked the same question to her. And in reply, what I get is a very wondrous response. She said, if you hold memories, it will flash back to you like Arabian Nights. And the whole tale will revolve around you, like a writer to your own story. Writing your destiny by yourself. If you look for moments, you will discern happiness and some twisted instant, which rest on the karma you have engaged with. It is never always about holding on to something. You should learn to let things go. I mean, why to hold such pain when your gear is drenched to drain? You cannot stop the ongoing time. And never mind if you are late. Be a wave who reaches the shoreline, not the one who is residing 100 miles away. So in this way she replied to me, and in the end, I really ended up by holding nothing in my hands. What I have was an experience. We take pictures to make memories, but we write to feel them. A feel which cannot be expressed through emotions, but sometimes with words. This day was also added to the catalogue of the golden memories, which had its own place in my heart and in this diary. you got time to spend with yourself and with your siblings, having a healthy conversations, poking at each other. I don't write often, but when I write about someone, it is either that person is so close to me, or I feel about him, or that event is too precious for me. And this is how my day ends up.